knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Now that we know what partial differential equations are, we can start learning how to solve them. We'll start with a fairly large class of first-order PDEs, those being the quasi-linear first-order PDEs. As mentioned in the previous tutorial, a quasi-linear PDE is any PDE where only its highest-order derivatives are multiplied by lower-order derivative terms. And the lower-order derivatives, or terms, can be non-linear in any way. For a first-order quasi-linear PDE, the most general form is then P of x, y, u times partial u partial x plus q of x, y, u times partial u partial y equals r of x, y, u, where p, q, and r are functions. The general way we can solve this for our function is called Lagrange's method of characteristics. Lagrange's method starts by writing down the simultaneous equation dx over p equals dy over q equals du over r, and this is known as the Lagrange-Charpit characteristic equation. From here, we can take any pair of terms and set them equal to each other. We get three possibilities. From the first and the second, we get dx over p equals dy over q, which gives us dy dx equals q over p. From the second and third, we get another equation, and from the first and third, we get yet another. Out of these three differential equations, which are all ODEs, we can pick any two of them to form a system of ordinary differential equations. If we are able to solve our system, we will get two characteristic curves. Call them phi 1 and phi 2, which are generally implicit solutions equal to a single constant of integration. Our general solution is then any function capital F of our two characteristics equal to 0, which we can rewrite generally as phi 2 equals some function F of phi 1. Let's see an example. Suppose we want to solve the PDE 2y partial u partial x plus u partial y equals 2yu squared. This is quasi-linear and first order, so we can write down our characteristic equation dx over 2y equals dy over u equals du over 2yu squared. Taking the first and second terms gives us the ODE dy dx equals u over 2y. Taking the second and third terms gives us the ODE du dy equals 2yu. We can't solve the first ODE yet, since it contains the unknown u, but we can solve the second ODE because it is separable. Recall that we can solve separable ODEs by separating the variables and then integrating both sides. We will get u equals c e to the y squared as our first characteristic. We can plug this expression for u into our first ODE to get dy dx equals c e to the y squared over 2y, which is also separable using integration by substitution. We will get cx plus e to the minus y squared equals d. We can eliminate the constant c in the second equation by rearranging the first and subbing in c equals ue to the minus y squared. And these will give our two linearly independent characteristics, phi 1 equals u e to the minus y squared, and phi 2 equals e to the minus y squared times 1 plus ux. The general solution is then phi 2 equals f of phi 1, and so we get this as our answer. This might not look like the types of solutions we are used to seeing for ODEs. It is clearly an implicit solution since we don't get u as an explicit function of x and y, only the relationship between the three variables. PDEs admit a much broader class of solutions than ODEs, and it is usually the boundary conditions that constrain this large group of general solutions into just one particular solution. There is an interpretation of why Lagrange's method works using concepts from multivariable calculus. If we consider the solution to our original quasi-linear PDE as a curved surface in 3D Cartesian coordinates with x, y, and u as the third axis, then we know that the surface normal vector to the surface u of xy is given by partial u partial xi plus partial u partial yj minus k, where I, j, and k are the orthonormal basis vectors along the x, y, and u axes, and we can think of this as a 3D normal vector field N. Next, we can easily write our PDE in the form v dot n equals 0, where v is another 3D vector field defined by pi plus qj plus rk. Since this dot product expands to give our PDE, it must define our solution u. Geometrically, recall that the dot product between two vectors is 0 only when they are perpendicular to each other. So if v dot n is 0, then it means that whenever our vector field v is perpendicular to our surface normal vector, that point is part of the solution. But being perpendicular to the surface normal is equivalent to being within the tangent plane to the surface, and so we can say that our solution exists wherever the vector field v points along the tangent planes of our surface. This is now equivalent to finding the field lines of our vector field v, which we may recall is easily done by setting the gradients in any perpendicular directions equal to the ratio of the vector field components, which is exactly what the Lagrange-Charpit characteristic equation does. Dx over p equals dy over q equals du over r. So that's how to solve what is probably the simplest class of PDEs, and you can see that it's already a bit trickier than the simplest ODEs. Sometimes Lagrange's method will yield ODEs with no closed-form solution. If this happens, there's not a lot more we can do algebraically, and we must resort to numerical methods or visualizations to get an idea of what the solution might look like. We should generally be aware that many PDEs are just not solvable at all, and that's just how it is. The techniques that we will learn in the coming tutorials are tried and tested for specific types of PDEs. Attempting to use the methods outside of what they were designed for will more often than not end in disappointment, just like in ODEs or even just algebraic equations. With that said, don't be afraid to experiment with finding different strategies for any PDEs you happen to come across. You just might uncover a new technique all by yourself. For now, let's check comprehension.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.